Okay, this is a mobile home electric furnace. Customer states, will not shut off. My suspicion is the bad sequencer. Right down there, that's the sequencer. We'll do some testing here and see what we got. Okay, checking for power. We have there. Let's shut off the breaker and see if it kills it, make it safe to work on. Okay, after turn off the breaker, verify there is no power on the bottom side. So all this stuff in here should now be safe to touch. But we'll double check just to make sure. Now we have this pulled out of here. And we can replace the other one, the new one, and just change wires one at a time. Okay, we now have our sequencer changed. Let's see if it works. Well, let's make sure that when the fan comes on, same time the amps are being drawn. It's got a 120 second delay, so it might take a minute. Maybe. There it goes. Fan came on. 47 amps, so the first two elements are on. And we wait. In a minute we'll hear a click. Amperage will go up as the other elements come on. Another 160 seconds, I think. Wow, that was a long, long time. Now you see we're at 85 and a half elements, so we know, or amps, so we know all four elements are burning. So we're at 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll make sure it sequences off properly. Well, here we go. It's an old Intherm, Radiotherm, four element mobile home electric furnace from approximately late 80s probably. Not a super hard job. Something you can do yourself at home if you're somewhat competent, but it's not for everybody. And if you're not comfortable, don't do it, because there are things in there that will hurt you very badly.